unmute myself. I always forget to unmute myself. Okay, guys, can you guys hear me? Is everything good and sound? There it is. There it is. I am alive. Okay, I'm alive. So again, oh, what a shocker, man. What a shocker, right? On Monday, I mean, unless you guys were in, I don't know where you guys were, unless you guys were in the South Pole. But I think the South Pole also has communication. So Elon Musk, Tesla, guys, Tesla. And this is so big, right? Tesla finally came out and finally said that they bought 1.5 billion worth of Bitcoin after Elon Musk kind of suggesting it. You know, he was putting Bitcoin on his Twitter, then he removed it, then he talked about Doge, and then he came up with Bitcoin. So remember that, okay? And look, now Monero wants Elon Musk to put what? To allow people to buy things with Tesla, right? To allow people to buy Tesla with Monero. Tesla said they would allow you to buy cars with Bitcoin, but that's on Monday. Let's go a quick one on this, because Monday we have a show specifically dedicated on how Elon's or Tesla's buying Bitcoin, what cryptos are really going to benefit from this or may benefit from this. You know, what are the good ones that you can look into really investing for the long term? Yes, there is a report that Apple might even do it. We don't know. Everyone is on edge now, because now look, it hits 1.4 trillion. It's just going up. It's just going up. It's just going up such that I will have to pay taxes, guys. I will have to pay taxes. I have mixed feelings, you know. I made like 10,000 US today, 10,000 US inadvertently because of all this news coming in, okay, related to Polkadot more than related to Tesla. But again, when the markets go up, hey, that's fine with me. I'm okay. Make 10,000 US, then you pay, and I'll tell you about it, okay? But man, everything is so hot now, okay? Like all this, right? And look at this. Yeah, Elon Musk. Okay, this is about carbon capture. So we learn about this on Monday, what he said. But look at this. Bitcoin could rally further as Tesla leads corporates on treasury investment. It looks like 50K is kind of wanting to pull Bitcoin there, you know? Just like I said last year, right? By Christmas, we have to hit 20K, which it did. Like it's like before it goes anywhere or before it starts with a correction, like it just has to go to 50K, right? But we don't know that. But that seems where people are looking at. And if enough people look at it, hey, guess what? It happens. After that, we do not know. Okay, so this is what's happening here. So the markets are looking good. The markets are looking very good. But tonight we want to talk about DOT. We want to finish on DOT because I have something very good on DOT for you guys. But remember, Monday, don't miss the show, okay? Because Monday, the show is very important. It is about Lord Elon and what other coins can it be influenced by this. And if you do not get approval to attend, listen to this, okay? You guys, gotta listen to this.
The dark side of the force is a pathway to many abilities some consider to be unnatural.
Did you hear that? You want to hear the dark side of the force? You want to hear the dark side of the force, guys? You have to be here on Monday, okay? Just be here on Monday to listen to the side of the force. It is so crucial, okay? It is so crucial, okay? It is really, 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 really crucial. But today, let's look at the markets. What is happening? Okay, the Bitcoin dominance is the same, but look at that market capitalization. Oh my God, it's 1.4 trillion, the highest ever in the history of cryptocurrency. Look at all the coins here, okay? Look at the price here. Oh, even XRP seems to be pumping. I don't know, there seems to be something going on at 10:30. I ain't part of it, okay? I don't want to be part of all these pump and dump things. But let's look at what's happening on the charts, okay? Let's look at what the charts are telling us. And I'll tell you what happened to my BNB, Binance coin. So you see Bitcoin here, that's 46K. Okay, Ethereum still hasn't broken up above 1,800, but looks pretty darn close. That's Stellar Lumens, right? I think we touched on this on this Wall Street Bets. And today, I don't know whether it's the real Wall Street Bets, but someone is arranging a pump or a dump, or you can get corn at 10:30 on XRP. So I will just take a look at it. Okay, but look at Dot, guys. Dot. Polkadot is pumping. Polkadot is pumping hard. Polkadot is very, very hard pumping. So you see what's happening now. If you want to know what's happening now, how I made $10,000 accidentally, okay? Well, I kind of made it faster than I wanted to, which could mean that it means I could have been trading, which means that I could be taxed. And I didn't want to be taxed, guys. I was buying for the long term. I am a hodler, okay? But anyway, Polkadot is pumping. And one of the big news on Polkadot now, you see, is actually coming here. Look at this. Parachain. Now, the first parachain on Polkadot is actually called Plasm Network. So look at what happened before. Binance Labs. Binance Labs announces investment in Plasm. What does that mean? It looks like Binance is going Polkadot way. So we need to know more about Polkadot, right? You guys want to take advantage of Polkadot, right? Listen up. I know you guys want to hear about Elon. That's Monday, right? Tell your partners to also come because, well, we have a lot of things on Elon Musk too. But anyway, Binance Labs announced it. You see what's happening now? Those who are in crypto know, right? Now, the problem with crypto now is that gas fees are so expensive. Gas fees are essentially the transaction fees. So you got to pay that, and it is so expensive. Did I see something here? FUD, no. There was something else. Good. Elon, don't bother me, okay? Yeah, okay. So the value is locked, but this is for the big time guys, not for the small guys, because it's so, so, so expensive nowadays, guys. So what Binance does, and I'm going to look at the Binance coin here, and I will tell you how I inadvertently made $10,000. Well, kind of made 11 with my dividend today on Flow. So I'm going to sell Flow and get a dividend of $2,000. How do you like that? Well, I think that's taxable. Okay, it's a dividend payment. So look at this. So Binance also has a chain. You know, you got Ethereum, right? We're talking about Ethereum so much. Binance also has a chain, and it's cheaper to do things on Binance. I think, Roy, you asked on Monday, right? I said Binance has a smart chain, and it has PancakeSwap. So PancakeSwap is like Uniswap, but much cheaper, right? And now you see Binance also going into Polkadot. And look what happened to Binance Coin, right? Look what happened to Binance Coin. Just look at this. I want you to show this. I want you to see. Now, I like Binance Coin. I have tons of Binance Coin. So I sold one big lot, but never mind. I went in at about 40 here, okay? I just went in about 40, guys. I went in about 40. That was like when? That was like somewhere here, man. When was that? That was January. Yeah, late January or something, you know. Late January, I went in at $40, okay? I wanted to hold this. If there are any tax people here, can you like read my, you know? This is like my confession again, confession, okay? We confess not to priests, we confess to the tax man. Anyway, I wanted to keep this, okay? So I got it bought at $40. I said, why not? Yeah. Buying it at 40 bucks. So, you know, thinking that, okay, see, Binance Coins is usually slow. It's very slow. So I'm saying that maybe if it goes up to 80, right? I'm saying this, it goes up to 80 and then it comes back. That's reasonable, guys, okay? And you know what? So I put in the TP of 138 here, which would give me a profit of $9,200. I kind of bought 100 BNB at like $4,000, right? So, you know, I just put in this TP of like 138 because I said, there's no way it's going to be hit. You know, it's going to be hit later, right? Like maybe in April, May. I was thinking of that. And look, guys, it hit. Darn, it hit. I am, you know, I have money now. I'm not happy. I have money. I'm like, again, you know, this is crypto people. Like, we are, whatever I said before, we are happily unhappy. You know, it was hit. So there's now $9,200 in here in my account, you know, my profit account. And I have another 2,000 like dividend that I got today. Is like $11,000. It is a problem. Okay, it is a problem. It's a good problem to have. I don't doubt it. So let's see why this happened, because not only was Binance going up because it was cheaper, right? They have pancake swap, which is cheaper. So this should bring in people from Uniswap and all the Ethereum here. But also because of the Polkadot factor, guys, remember that? That news, that Plasm network, that they are giving money to Polkadot. So they are contributing to Polkadot. And the hottest thing is what? Polkadot DeFi, okay? Polkadot DeFi, total Polkadot DeFi is super, super hot, right? And look what happened, man. I made a TP, guys. I am sorry. See, this is why I don't name TPs. If I name TPs to my guys, you know, I'd be going, you know what? I'm the crypto Sifu. Let's put it at 138. Fat, it will never get hit. I don't know where to put my face. I'm going to say that, Fat, I'm sorry you guys made money. I am so sorry if you guys made money. Okay, I just did not intend for that to happen, man. I did not intend for that to happen. So sometimes, you know, we crypto guys, I have to ask for forgiveness if you guys made money, because someone made money from this also. I mean, this is just the thing, okay? This is just the thing with crypto, the exciting thing. So let's go into Polkadot. Why is it so darn exciting? Because February and March is when Polkadots start their parachain. Okay, understand that? This is the parachain network, the networks that bond into Polkadot. And when you look what Polkadot is all about, which is very interesting here, I want you to understand, look, staking. What does staking mean and bonding? Okay, again, you want to connect to Polkadot here. If you are a new parachain, and we saw just now, right, Binance is investing in Plasm, right? Binance is investing in Plasm, my friends. You have to actually stake and bond. That means you have to buy a token. It could be DOT. You know, you guys like basically put it here inside the Polkadot network. That's what you do. You put a lot of DOTs here. So your DOTs is here. To unbond and to unstake takes about 28 days, which is too long, okay? So when you talk about Polkadot, the main one, there are only 100 parachains available. 100, count that, 100. And they sell by auction, you know? They sell by auction. People have to put their DOTs here. Now, this is good. You know why this is good? Because this reduces the pressure, right? Because people are buying DOT. Guys, why are they buying DOT? They're buying DOT not to sell. They're buying DOT to keep for the long term. You see that? Because there's not much pressure, right? They're buying DOT to put here. They're buying DOT. Okay, now these are very, very expensive. And that's why you see people like Plasm here, right? Like Plasm here. And this is how you know it's a good project. And Plasm is a good project. Congratulations for you all in the US show who got into this, right? Congratulations. Congratulations, guys. But I don't have to, I hope I don't have to ask for forgiveness. You make money, okay? Resolve it with your tax agent, not me, okay? But anyway, it's live on Rococo. And then Binance put something because it does cost money to go into Polkadot. Get that? And then the bigger guy comes in and puts money into you. So if you can find projects like this, guys, you know you got a winner. But other than Polkadot, so what if they don't have enough money? What if they want to start small? What if they want to start small? Well, Polkadot, guys, has another network. This is the wild cousin of Polkadot. This is Kusama. It is the Canary Network. It's risk-taking, okay? It's for risk-taking, fast-moving canary in the coal mine. Because what happened last time was there was a canary, okay? And the canaries were sent into the coal mine to make sure that there was enough oxygen. And if the canary died, people would just go out of the coal mine. Rest in peace, canaries. You guys want to be canaries, right? You guys have to be canaries first. So anyway, Kusama is cheaper, right? Kusama is cheaper now. You guys learning something? Give a like, guys. Give a like. Give a share and subscribe to the channel, okay? Give a like, give a share, and subscribe to the channel. So what you can do is actually, rather than buying Polkadot, you can also buy Kusama. Or you can buy both, or you can buy one of them together. Because let me see. Let me look to you. Let me show you what's happening. So it was also founded by Gavin Wood, which is the founder of Polkadot, okay? And it does a lot of cool things on Kusama because they're not as strict as Polkadot. See, fast iteration, you can change things. Low economic barriers, of course, it's low barriers to entry. It's cheaper. Advanced technology, it's just advanced as Polkadot, right? Because, you know, they're like brother and sister or cousins. It's like open governance. It's an engaged community. Now, this is important. The the community is very strong. Do you want to be part of Kusama? Well, I don't know. We'll decide, guys. If there are more than five people, we should be part of the strong Kusama network. Where do you buy Polkadot? You can buy Polkadot in exchanges like Binance. You can buy it in the wallet like, crypto.com. Kusama too, okay? Kusama too. Because once you know Polkadot, you guys got to be knowing Kusama, okay? The cousin of Polkadot, okay? The cousin of Polkadot. And remember, the cousin, but it's a wild, dangerous cousin of Polkadot, okay? Yeah. Shaheen asked the question there. Because in Polkadot, R&D means research and development, but in Kusama, it means risk and danger. And you can have more stuff on Kusama, actually. And I'll tell you, is that company in here? Yes, no, Kusama is cheaper. Market cap is cheaper. The price is not cheaper. The price is 100, yeah. But it's not cheaper, okay? So just read through this, okay? Understand this. So both are built on Substrate, the Canary network. You join the Kusama ecosystem there, Polkadot, Akala, which will be the stable coin there. You guys know Chainlink. You got no Chainlink, right? This coin almost got me liquidated, man. I got freaked out. I am not trading Chainlink again. I like Oracle's me. I'm not trading Chainlink again because of the scare. It wasn't centralized at Moonbeam. We're going to talk more about Moonbeam after it. Fala. Fala is what? Fala is the security layer of Polkadot and Kusama. Edgeware, who has this coin? Fad, I know you have this coin. It's done a 4x. It's only done a 4x, okay? It's only done a 4x, Edgeware. So cool. Hasn't done a 10 times yet, okay? So anyway, let's now go look at the guy called Kusama. Hey, let's go here, man. So yeah, let's see Kusama, the wild cousin, okay? Kusama, where was that? I thought I saw it. Okay, here. Yeah, this is Kusama. See, so Kusama, it seems, is also pumping together with Polkadot. It was $50 when we were buying it. It's 133. Where do you think it goes? Oh, it already went to 150. I did not know that. It already went to 150. So it is lower market capitalization than Polkadot because let's talk about Kusama. It's very low, you know, so it can go higher. Of course, it can go higher. And remember that the activity starts on Kusama first, not Polkadot, okay? Kusama first, because people want to test things on Kusama. What's the market cap? 1.2 billion. Yes, it's more expensive, but it's cheaper than Polkadot. Let me show you how to do this. So Kusama is 1.2 billion. Let me see what Polkadot is. No, not PolkaStarter. Polkadot. Man, PolkaStarter, PolkaStarter has given us a 10 to 15X, right? 10 to 15X. Not 10% to 15%, 10 times to 15 times. Okay, let's see Polkadot now. You see 1.2 billion on Kusama, on Polkadot. And here, you see Polkadot is 23. So Polkadot is 23 times the size of Kusama. Do you think that's a proper thing? I think Kusama has a bit of catching up to do, but we need more activities on Kusama, okay? We need more activities on Kusama. But really what I like about Kusama is the statement that they have a strong community. So look at this, guys. Look at Kusama. Do you know that? This crypto fraternity will pay you $3,000 to get a tattoo. This is the Kusama Human Blockchain Project. Can you believe that? You can get a Kusama, a canary tattoo, and they're going to pay you because what happens is the coins, okay, the coins that are burned are not really burned. They are going inside this fraternity, right? They call it fraternity, right? What does it call? Yeah, they call it Kappa Sigma Mu, the Kusama fraternity. So you guys go, hey, knockers, man. You can go, yeah. High five, and let's show your Kusama tattoo. I don't know if they want it at a certain anatomy. I do not know. Go ask them, okay? So you can have a tattoo, guys. So, I mean, if I'm going out with a girl now, you know what? I have changed. I now have to look for a girl who already has a tattoo because that is going to be difficult. But I also have to make sure and check with the fraternity that, hey, you know, there is space. Please make sure that there is space on her body to have a tattoo, okay? Make sure that 2.54 cm. That's how strong the Kusama fraternity is, huh? So now you see girls with a tattoo, man. You're like, hey, you are my type of girl, man. You are the crypto girl, right? You're going to say to her, hey, we can go Kusama, man. We can become Kusama mates, yeah? And you can use like, you know, both of you get, well, what is it now? I think now it's worth 4,500 or something. Man, 9,000 bucks, guys. Hey, Kishan, you can buy her a ring, dude. You can buy her an engagement ring. I didn't know. Isn't this cool, right? Now, isn't this cool? Like, they have things like this. So this is how strong the Polkadot ecosystem is. Again, Kusama also has its own ecosystem. And you saw a company there called Moonbeam. So here's the thing. In order to apply, the same thing as Polkadot, right? In order to apply for a parachain on Kusama, which you want to try things first, you have to have Kusama, you have to bond it. You know, you have to stake it, you have to bond it, right? Now let's look at Moonbeam. Let's look at how Moonbeam is doing this, okay? This is very, very important, so listen up. So the future is multi-chain. So I think there's news about Moonbeam here. I read it just now. Where's Moonbeam? Da-da-da-da-da-da, let's see Moonbeam. Then the Polkadot way, Testnet Rococo. Let's see on Moonbeam here. They have a very good news on Moonbeam. Okay, so look at that parachain, right? Equilibrium is also going after a parachain, and Moonbeam is also going after a parachain. Okay, let's see a parachain on Polkadot. And there's a lot of things happening in Moonbeam, that chain bridge. Finally, guys, Moonbeam has completed the bridge to Ethereum. That means it's easy to bring in applications to Ethereum. Okay, it's easy to bring in applications onto Ethereum, guys. So this is very important. Roy asked pre-search. I don't know what pre-search is, Roy. Sorry. I only focus on certain things that are that I feel have a chance to make money. Okay, or a good chance to make money. Anyway, so a chain bridge is finally ready. And this is a good development for Moonbeam. That means they are going somewhere. So now we have to ask ourselves, wait, okay, if Moonbeam has this, how then is it approaching the Polkadot ecosystem, the Polkadot parachain, and does it have something on Kusama, okay? So again, this is important. You know, all those applications that you like on Ethereum that is expensive can now be ported over to Polkadot. You can use the same thing like your favorite MetaMask, right? And you don't have to pay high gas fees. Isn't that cool? Which is why even Binance is putting money in Polkadot, right? Binance is putting money in Polkadot in Plasm. We hope that one day the big guys, and I'm sure this will happen, the big guys is also going to put money into Moonbeam, okay? So let's see how they do this. Are they going in one or are they going in two? How do you invest in Moonbeam? I will show you now. Look at this, Roy. Look at this. Look at that. Kaboom. Yeah, you look at tokens here. They have two. And now there were two. Why are they two? Now, this is weird, right? Because you guys are asking about XRP. There is one, right? You guys are asking about Binance, BNB. There is one. Well, actually, there's not one. There's BNB, there's Pancake and all that. But anyway, so Moonbeam, there's Glimmer. Glimmer is the main one on Polkadot. You see that? Glimmer is numero uno, the bigger one, but that is on the Polkadot parachain. You get me here? This is good, right? So this, we'll see when this. So this is a public launch. Public launch means you guys are going to have to fight with each other. Like, yeah. And what if you have to fight me? Ha 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 ha. Not easy, guys. Not easy, guys. You are going to have to fight the experts, right, to get this much, 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 much desired token, because there's a lot of things that are happening here. Okay, Relay Chain on Polkadot. Glimmer anticipated launch Q2 2020. It is coming soon. So you have to ask, can I get it? But guess what Moonbeam is doing? And this is good. This shows that Moonbeam is very well funded. And of course, if it gets funded from outsiders, maybe like Binance, maybe like Huobi Labs, Binance Lab, maybe Coinbase Labs, I don't know. Guess what? It is gonna go somewhere, okay? So you have River, and what are they doing about River? This is the utility token of the Moon River Network. What is this, guys? There is the Kusama deployment. That means they put Moonbeam on Kusama, it's called Moon River, right? This is the wild cousin, right? So that they are going to get it right when it eventually goes on to Polkadot, correct? Supply and other will be the same as Moonbeam, yeah, everything and other token economics. Moon River will serve as the canary net for Moonbeam. What does that tell you? That means when people develop something, they test it first on Moon River, and then it goes to Moonbeam, right? Moonbeam will use a large parachain crowd loan. What is a crowd loan? To obtain its initial parachain slot on Kusama, which means that if you want to participate in Moon River and you want to be kind of like an owner in Moon River, a stakeholder, not an owner, you need to buy Kusama, right? When is it? It's coming soon. See that? So let's see how this happens. Okay, so again, yeah, from Moonbeam, yeah, for Moon River, you invest in this. Okay, what is this? That's from Monday. Okay, that's from Monday. No, in Moon River, you invest through Kusama. In Moonbeam, you have to invest through Polkadot or whatever they call us. But look, what will happen? For Moon River, there will be a Kusama crowd loan plan at the end of the quarter. End of the quarter means end of March. Public sale of Glimmer in quarter two. This is where you have to fight with each other. So if you think you are a Jedi, if you want to go against the Jedis, you go here, okay? But please, guys, you have to have your lightsaber ready. Do you have your lightsaber ready? And remember, when you go here, remember you are up against these people. Did I see that there? No, I didn't see that there. Where is the video? Okay, it's not there. Anyway, you are up against the people. You are up against the people of the dark side who have unnatural abilities, right? So that is, that's kind of Moon River, right? That's kind of Moonbeam, right? But if you go to Moon River, guess what, guys? If you are going to Moon River, where was this? Guess right. If you're going to Moon River, you buy your Kusama. And what do, guys? You lock your Kusama. You lock your Kusama for a set period. This is 2 years. It's about 2 years, estimate up to 2 years for locking. So what you do is this, okay? Let me draw it for you here. You have, let me change it to yellow here. And this is why I like this way of investing. Okay, you lock your Moon, you lock your KSM here, and this is Moon River. And when you do that, guess what, guys? You get rewards. It's like dividends, right? You get River tokens. You get River tokens, which is Moon River. You receive River tokens. You do not need a lightsaber. Here, you need a lightsaber. You got to fight like that, la, 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 right? Here, you don't. You get your River token as long as it's locked, right? And guess what? At the end of 2 years, this is what happens. You're asking, hey, what happens to my move, my Kusama? No, you will get your Kusama back. After 2 years, you will get your Kusama back. It's a loan. You see this? It's a loan. It is a crowd loan. You see that? It is a crowd loan. Okay. 2 years, the Glimmer public sale. Yeah. Then it's very different. So really there are two ways. Okay, guys, there are two ways to get into this exciting, super exciting project from Moonbeam. You can get into the Canary Network by buying. And I think we'll get the instruction soon. And then bonding, you know, giving them a loan for Kusama, getting River later. You can go to a crowd sale and Glimmer. So Moonbeam packs a two-punch. It's two-punch, like this, and this, and this. Right? It's two-punch. Now, isn't that great? Because this shows that, you know, they're doing the right thing. They're following the right process. They are not really trying to make it quick, right? They're taking their steps, and I like this, okay? This is the way it should be. Plus, I also like the fact that in this, you know, you have to lock your Kusama. What have we been saying? What have we been saying, right? When this comes, when we are the small guy and we want to be the big guy, you want to make 10K like me and get stacks, that's okay. What do you say, guys? I am possible. Hold the line, right? I am possible. Hold the line. What are you doing with Kusama for 2 years, guys? You are essentially holding the line. You are holding the line because you can't do anything. Hold the line. Now, I do not know what the price of Kusama would be at the end of 2 years. I do not know that, but I do know that someone We will need, yeah, Hanan, we will know then. We will know then the minimum. That's a good question, right? But I do know that someone who likes staking, and his name is Brian, and you know what he did? This is not for Kusama. This is for a different project called PERP. No, I forgot the name. Well, it's not PERP, right? PERP is kind of perpetual. It's another name project. But he locked this thing called Luna. He locked this thing called Luna. And now, after he locked it for a certain period, it wasn't long. I think it's about a month plus. And then he had to unbond it. Now that the time he gets it, guess what? How much has this gone up by? 10 times, guy? 10 times. That means if he had locked up 1,000 and he sells today, it would be 10,000. I do not know if this is going to happen to Kusama. I don't know. But at least I know that this is the way to do it. So we will end with what? What do we end with, guys? What are we going to end with? I am possible. Hold the line, guys. Hold the line. Goodbye. Over and out.